Welcome to the Raymarching Shader tutorial by PeerPlay. In this tutorial series, I will teach you step by step how to write a Raymarching Shader in Unity. In this first part, I will visually explain the basic concepts of Raymarching. For those of you who are new to my channel, I create tutorials about audio visualizations, algorithms, and shaders using Unity Engine. Creating these free tutorials takes a lot of time and effort, and I couldn't have created these without the support of all the amazing patrons at my Patreon. If you find the contents of my tutorials helpful, consider supporting me at Patreon. In doing so, you not only support me creating these, but you get access to the source files, exclusive tutorials, and extra content. Special thanks to MR, Andrew Laboy, Devin the Dude, Derek Fegter, and Patrick Nugent. I will teach you how to implement Raymarching into your Unity workflow. There's a lot to learn, and we're gonna do some more advanced coding. So if you are completely new to writing shaders, I advise you to watch my series on creating a spherical mask shader. This will teach you some of the basics of writing shaders. It's early 2001 and I just celebrated my 14th birthday. I found this 64 kilobytes demo by Farbrausch, the product. I'm not gonna play it now, so please pause the video and check the link in the description. You can imagine how amazed I was by its size and content, including 3D graphics with textures and an amazing soundtrack. These coders that I've never met were and remain to be my heroes. This is probably the reason why I started coding audio visualizations. I don't think this demo uses Raymarching but draws triangles in direct 3D, but there's another link in the description to one that does. Okay, so Raymarching is a 3D rendering technique often used in the Demoscene because of its simplicity and speed. So, what is Raymarching exactly and how does it work? To explain this, I need you to imagine some 3D object floating between your eyes and the screen you are watching this on. A Raymarching shader is in screen space. This means that we project our calculations onto a quad or camera, or in this example your screen. The object you imagined is called our signed distance field, or SDF, which is a mathematical equation in 3D space. Now imagine, you have superpowers and you can cast from your eyes a laser beam to the screen. The point you are looking at is a certain pixel on screen. For that pixel, the laser beam, or ray, will find the closest blocking imaginary shape. If it hits the shape, it will draw a color to the screen. If it doesn't hit anything, it draws this video. The graphics card will calculate the laser beam for all the pixels on the screen each frame. Can you imagine the shadow appearing on the video? Now we need a calculation of an approximation of the distance from our eyes to the object, so we can use that distance to get a position in space. With this scene, I hope to explain the distance estimator, sphere tracing. In the top right corner, you see the camera that will render the distance field. A camera renders in screen space onto a quad. To get the direction of all the rays for each pixel, the camera creates a frustum based on the field of view. If we increase the field of view, the quad will grow, and the directions of the ray will be more spread out. Let's reset the field of view to 60. Sphere tracing is a technique used to measure the distance from the camera to the distance field by marching steps of imaginary spheres. We start at the origin position and measure the closest distance with a result not equal to zero. If that position is not along the ray direction, we march forward with the radius of the sphere because we can be sure that all the space in between is empty. We then repeat this process until we get a negative result as output distance. In this example, we only need 8 marches to find the position for this pixel. This way of calculating distances is a very fast rendering technique. So once we hit the object, we can tell the shader what color to draw and what shading to use. If we just draw a color, we won't see any 3D because the 3D effect is created by some surfaces that have brighter and darker colors based on a light source. I will teach you how to calculate the normal direction of the position we've hit and use that normal direction to calculate a Lambertian lighting model by using a dot product on the light direction and the normal direction. We can later add more shading effects like reflection, ambient occlusion, shadows, bloom, depth of field, multiple colors, textures, transparency, or translucency. Let's take a dive inside the signed distance field, which is a float function with a float 3 position input. This is the current Raymarch position. The output float value tells us if we have hit the distance field or not. We can define a surface by writing a signed distance function. The easiest to start with is a sphere. A sphere is nothing more than a position and a certain scale or radius. Functions output a minus value if we are inside the surface, and we only want to draw the surface if we have a negative output. Now let's add a box to the scene, which we can achieve by this equation. To show both the sphere and the box, we need to return the minimum result of both primitives in the distance field function. Let's place the sphere and the box at the same position. We can add Boolean operators to the primitives, for example by subtracting the sphere from the box. By adding a lerp to the operator, we can achieve a smooth subtraction. By applying fmod to a position axis, we can repeat the distance field at a certain interval. This is very cheap to calculate for the shader, because it only has to calculate the initial object. In this example, we tell the shader that if the position is above 4, to take the same values counting from 0 in the distance field. We can apply this to all axes, which returns an infinite space of the same pattern. Eventually, we will create a scene containing multiple metaballs with different colors. We can then make the Raymarching shader react to the incoming audio using my audio peer system. You can learn all about audio visualization in Unity with my tutorial series on that subject. I hope that by now you have some basic understanding of what a Raymarching shader is. In the next part, we will start by setting up the camera in Unity and write the basic requirements of the shader. For now, I want to thank you for watching this video. If you want to stay updated to new released parts, subscribe to this channel and turn the notifications on. Happy coding!